Your job as actors is to understand the size of what you say, to understand what's beneath the word. Stella Adler. Theater can impact you in a way that nothing else can. It has a way of showing the reality of human nature, even when it takes us out of reality. It can show the inner workings of the human mind. It can bring people from tears of laughter to tears of heartache in just a few sentences. And that is special. But where did all of this begin? Allow me to bring you back in time, to ancient times specifically, and I'll show you. I'm Bree, and welcome to the Scholarly Cheese Guild. So what did theater look like in ancient times? Well, let's go back to ancient Greece. In ancient Greece, the plays were performed by primarily men. I say primarily because there are still debates as to whether or not women were included. And the three different genres were comedy, satyr, and tragedy, and these were the backbone of Greek theater. As far as historians are aware, theater primarily began in ancient Greece, and Rome adopted it a little bit after that. It is fully possible that theater could have been started in another place before Greece, but if it did, we have no record of it. The word theater may be derived from Old English, but it has roots in Greek. The Greek word being theatron, or theistai, meaning behold. There have been some debates as to whether or not theater stemmed from rituals, with even Aristotle making a case for this and likening theater to sacred mysteries, whatever those are. However, there isn't a lot of evidence to support this claim, so many historians have dismissed it. Comedic plays were mainly satirical in nature and often made fun of people, primarily with power, for their foolish and vain nature. Some famous playwrights from this genre include Aristophanes and Menander. Menander wrote comedies that are much like our modern-day sitcom. Before we get into the other two genres, let's take a quick break and head over to the Mischief Corner.
Hello there. Welcome to the Mischief Corner. Now, I'm sure I could talk all day about how boring. But you don't want to hear them. No, you're here for the facts. The factists. Now, today we're talking about your mother jokes. You see, there have been ancient ones. There have been the first ones ever, but we're not talking about the first. We're talking about the best. The best of the best. Enter William Shakespeare. A great innovator of the theater. And perhaps one of the best Your Mama Jokes writers of all time. I could go two different examples of different plays that have Your Mother Jokes, but I feel like the best one draws from Titus Andronicus. Titus Andronicus features a Your Mama joke that is unlike any other, and yet so like them all. You see, in Titus Andronicus, one of the characters is with his brother, and they are confronting a villain. He says, "Villain, what hast thou done?" Then another says, "I have done what thou canst not undo." Then the other brother says, "Thou hast undone our mother." And then the punchline. "Nay, villain, I have done thy mother."
I can definitely see William Shakespeare doing that. But let's get back to genres. Satyr plays were essentially comedic relief for tragedies. They would be performed between acts of tragedies, and they made fun of the tragedy characters and their issues. The reason they're called satyr plays is because the actors would dress up as the mythical creature, the satyr, who are half man, half goat, and are very present in Greek mythology. Sometimes these plays are referred to as tragicomics or comedy dramas by playwrights. This leads us to our last genre, the tragedy, which is kind of self-explanatory. Tragedies deal with big ideas and themes like loss, love, abuse of power, pride, and bad relationships between man and the gods. Typically, the main character commits some selfish or terrible act, often without realizing it, and as they go through the story, they tend to realize how terrible of a person they are and have to deal with the consequences of their actions. Some famous playwrights of tragedies are Euripides, Aeschylus, pardon my bad pronunciation, and Sophocles. Ancient theater, specifically Greek, has impacted modern theater more than you might think. Even though it was so long ago when theater started, we still use the genres Greece used, and actually, they're oftentimes the backbone of modern genres as well. William Shakespeare, arguably the most famous playwright in all of history, himself, used these genres in his shows, and some of his plays are even rumored to be remakes of the ancient Greek shows. But it's more than just genres that Greece produced. Ancient Greece, and then Rome after that, made theater popular throughout many nations, and Western theater would not be the way it is today without the influence, which, as a side note, would be very sad. I extend my heartfelt gratitude to all who have partaken in today's historical odyssey. To delve further into the vast realm of knowledge, I implore you to pledge your allegiance to the channel and heed the beckoning chime of the notification bell. Should this intellectual voyage have ignited a spark within, I beseech thee to kindle the flames of camaraderie by bestowing upon it your likes and sharing it with fellow seekers of wisdom. I just saw you dying in the background.